hand-sized superb specimen of cobalt and calcite, a lawn of cobalt and calcite sitting on a young dolomite matrix, little bit of dendritic formation in the dolomite, and quite typical, you have the crusty effect of the cobalt and calcites. It's as if these dolomites brecciated and were a juice of cobalt and calcite a high content calcite with cobalt inclusion, or high content calcite, of course, with cobalt, high cobalt content calcite. Sorry, I got stuck there. Ran through these cracks and essentially stuck these sections of dolomite together. Now we're going to have a closer look at the formations on here. You'll see over here, those would be tiny waxy looking black botryoids of heterogenite sitting across there. Going across there, I don't see any other associations. Maybe some malachite or vesigia, right? Let's have a look on top there. It could be heterogenite too. So please look at my description for more info. Color wise, this is a pretty accurate color, maybe a little bit lighter. That's overexposed. That's pretty accurate. A very, very strange color of pink, as is the case in most of these cobalt and calcites. And the camera doesn't quite get the color right, but this gives you a pretty good indication. Lovely form on this piece. Really like this one. And size-wise, pretty good size. So this would be a cabinet-size specimen, all the way from the Tenke Fungurumu mine in the Katanga Copper Crescent of the Congo. Look at that, lovely. Let's see if we can get a little bit closer and have a good zoom in there. That is overexposed, but as you can see, a crystalline lawn with these little botryoids of the heterogenite sitting on top.